Altruism has been a prevalent issue in film studies since it was first addressed in the Cahiers du Cinéma. It was launched as part of a battle plan for reforming the French film industry to allow control of filmmaking by the workers. Additionally, the emphasis on mise-en-scène has since had a long-standing and substantial impact on auteur studies. Literally translating to placing on stage, it refers to all the elements visible in a shot. Throughout the years, many auteurs have developed a distinctly recognizable filmmaking style through their diverse use of mise-en-scène. Cahy argues that it is with the mise-en-scène that the auteur transforms the material which has been given to him. A successful contemporary example of such an auteur is Wes Anderson. Wes Anderson has written and directed 10 feature films, with these garnering both critical and commercial success. And as Koons states, one source of this adoration and denunciation of Wes Anderson's films appears to be the director's visual style. Anderson's style derives from his use of mise-en-scène, for example the distinctive settings of his films. These include the suitably pathetic Camp Ivanhoe of Moonrise Kingdom, the dreary Belafonte ship from The Life Aquatic with Steve Zissou, and the spectacular titular hotel of the Grand Budapest Hotel. Each set is carefully designed to feel suitably absurd, riddled with cultural references and an abundance of meaning that reflects the characters in the film. Anderson himself is heavily involved in the production design of his films and takes an almost forensic approach to the look of his sets. Anderson's interaction with this aspect of mise-en-scène supports the idea that the auteur is the main creative voice throughout many aspects of production. One of the most striking and recognizable aspects of Anderson's visual style is his approach to shot composition. In Rushmore, he makes extensive use of gimbal and tripod shots, rejecting the shaky handheld style of camera operation. It gives the film a strange, unnatural feel and reflects the fake theatrical nature of the characters and the narrative as a whole. Anderson's unique identity as an auteur continued to develop throughout his filmography. Hillier writes, "The originality of the auteur lies not in the subject matter he chooses, but in the technique he employs, i.e. the mise-en-scène through which everything on the screen is expressed." This is especially true of Anderson, where many of his iconic codes and conventions originate through his use of mise-en-scène. The precise usage of framing in his shot compositions are instantly recognizable, creating beautiful and complex images. In films like The Grand Budapest Hotel, he makes use of the intricate geometry of his grandiose sets to create ridiculously symmetrical images. Anderson's use of colour also contributes to this. Koons addresses the striking use of primary colours that seem to integrate a 1960s and 1970s style into the hard-to-pin-down present. The frequent usage of pink in the colour palette feels unnatural and evokes surrealist art and cinema. This comedically contrasts the flamboyant performances of his actors, together crafting the ironic absurdity of the Grand Budapest Hotel. Furthermore, it represents how impactful mise-en-scène has been on Anderson's identity as an auteur. In recent years, Anderson has also produced the Oscar-nominated stop-motion animated films Fantastic Mr. Fox and Isle of Dogs. Stop-motion animation is very distinct from other approaches to filmmaking. The delicately crafted characters and detailed sets of films like Coraline and The Nightmare Before Christmas contrast those of hand-drawn and computer-animated films. Yet Anderson is able to separate his work from other stop-motion animated films, achieved by incorporating his own visual style into his films through mise-en-scène. Camera techniques like his precise use of zooms, pans, tilts, and the lack of shaky cam are reminiscent of his live-action work, as is the use of symmetry in the shot composition. It is through this that Anderson proves how his unique visual style is transferable across mediums, outlining the importance of mise-en-scène to an auteur. In conclusion, Wes Anderson has become a frequent discussion topic in modern auteur studies. Through the striking use of colour in The Grand Budapest Hotel, the outlandish sets and locations of The Life Aquatic with Steve Zissou, and the symmetrical framing in his stop-motion work, Anderson has crafted a style that has been parodied time and time again, such as this advertisement for American Express.
"I've blown up buildings, hunted sharks, crashed airplanes, and flown helicopters. Anyway, American Express commercial, here we go."
Anderson himself is comparable with the rise of the director as superstar, as media celebrity that erupted from the New Hollywood movement. It could be argued that his recognizable style is a result of his creative use of mise-en-scène, signifying its central role in Anderson's image as an auteur.